I wanted to get your own thoughts on it. I mean, I know you got it, you're focused on this one fight, but do you look into the future, and what do you see happening with the victory in this fight? I mean, will you proceed on to a Wilder fight, possibly even by the end of the year? And can you sense, like Dan was asking you about the 90,000 at Wembley Stadium, just how great the excitement is for the heavyweights again?
Yeah, it's definitely exciting, for sure. It's definitely exciting. It's annoying because I'm getting up there. Well, why is the Wilder sold out 90,000? This guy has been pro for like 8 years, 9 years. 30-something, you know what I mean? And now I'm coming along, people who keep on mentioning my name. So it's tough because I ain't had a chance to learn. I'm going in at the deep end every time. But if Wilder wants some of his work, we can definitely get it on ASAP. There's no problem. And I don't mind coming to stateside because, you know, it's, even though boxing is booming in the UK, you don't want to be, you know, the sort of fighter that stays in the backyard all the time. You want to travel and go around and play the title. I feel.
I'm telling you, you're a break
division. I'm like, let's get it on now. So, if this is what comes with stepping up a level in a position, I'm all for it, man. And I'm not going to start saying, oh, because I'm champion now, I feel fresh and I don't think I'm going to perform. I'm just saying that. I think sometimes if you take a loss, you can try and defend yourself and ask yourself, why, how did this thing happen? So, I think maybe he's at a place where he's saying, what's up here? Is my fresh as a champion? And you start happening for a reason. So, for me as a champion, I don't feel that pressure. I can't relate to where he's coming from. But as a champion, you're supposed to throw it down like there's no tomorrow. So I'm not going to say, oh, because I'm a champion, I've got so much pressure on my hands, I'm not going to give it my all. But that's what it sounds like this show saying to me.
Yeah. All right, well, thank you for that.
I made it to England very nicely early this morning. I look forward to seeing you later today. But my question for you is there's been a lot of talk leading up to this fight, how quickly it sold out, how Eddie Hearn had to go to the folks at the London City Council and get them to add another 10,000 seats to the capacity to put it at 90,000. I'm wondering from your point of view, I saw a big billboard of you when I was coming from Heathrow Airport to the hotel on the side of the road. Why do you think this fight has taken off the way it has? I mean, you know, you and Klitschko have not had any trash talk between you guys, been very respectful of each other, maybe even friendly to a certain degree, which is, you know, the trash talk usually what maybe pumps up certain fights. Why do you suppose it's taken off like no other fight I've seen in my almost 20 years covering boxing?
Maybe we've just been true to ourselves. We've come up, people have watched Klitschko for many years.
You're hearing that, Dan, but Anthony, you're breaking up quite a bit there. I'm not sure if your cell service is, if you're traveling or where exactly you are, but if you could try to get to a good cell service spot, we can hear you better.
It's not bad.
I'm here, where did that go? I'll let the next person ask and look to see Anthony later on.
Hello?
Yeah, we hear you, Anthony.
Okay.
Operator, yeah. You want to try the next question?
Our next question comes in line of Lance Pugmire with Los Angeles Times.
Hi, Anthony. Thank you for being on today.
No problem at all. Thank you.
Anthony, the ultimate question I think for this fight is, how do you bridge the experience gap between Klitschko? And how do you, what do you think he's going to do to sort of impose that upon you. You know, that he's been involved in all these title fights. He's seen everything. He may see something in you that he's going to try to pick apart. What do we expect here, and how are you going to solve that riddle?
How will I win? What you're asking? How will I, even though he's been in so many fights, how will I beat Klitschko?
Yeah.
I just think it's destiny. I think I'm meant for this. I'm built for this. You know? Like, let's say we strip away, you know, what you just said there, the excitement, the hype, and then we just put us together and say, go at it, 12 rounds, get down and dirty. I have the ability to come out on top, and that's how I take it. I don't look at it like, oh my God, I'm fighting a guy I don't look at it that way. I just look at it as that, oh, I'm going to fight this guy for a very big kick up. And we've got 12 rounds left. We've got to get in that person. That's I simplify it. I break it right.
Yeah. And you're talking about, I mean, obviously 14 years younger, more power. Just kind of come at him with that and see how he deals with you. Is that what you're saying?
No, because I think that's more like a Mike Tyson-esque power, like aggressive. I practice boxing, you know, long range, jab, up to the body. And I just think that I'm very capable of hitting someone continuously until they break down. So I think I'll keep on plugging away, round 6, 7, and then I should have him hopefully in a bad place where, you know, when you can't perform as you did in round 1, to which is high end. I just have to check my mind and break it right in round 1.
Usually imposes on his opponent.
I've never fought him, so I couldn't say. But what will I do about his reach? I've got my right hand to parry jab. I've got my left hand to the shoulder, and the head movement to deflect the right hand. It's no problem. If he wants to grab, then I can whip in a body shot, and that would definitely slow him down. You know, I keep on getting hit to the body at 41. That will take the fight out of anyone. So I think on the outside, I've got ways to deal with the majority of his shots. And on the inside, I just have to keep on swinging to the body and slowly take the toll. And that's what I'm saying. Round by round, I'll start seeing an effect.
Yeah. You know, we spoke to Deontay Wilder on Monday, Anthony, and he was talking about the excitement of the division now. And
so there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.